In this video, let us look at what a transitive relation is. So if R is a relation defined on A, again, R is said to be transitive if A, B, B, C belongs to R implies that A, comma C belongs to R. That is, if two ordered pairs of the form A, comma B and B, comma C are present in R, the ordered pair A, comma C should always be present in R. That is, if A is related to an element B, B is related to an element C, A has to be related to C. So you have to see B, B have to take care of these two. If the element of the form A, comma B and B, comma C, these two elements are same. If two ordered pairs of this form are present in the relation R, A, comma C should also belong to R. So this is the definition of transitive relation. For example, if you take R is a relation defined on n to n and R contains elements of the form x comma y such that x is greater than y. So is this a transitive relation? Yes. Why? So I'll say that. So let us assume that two elements of the form let A comma B and B comma C belong to this relation. So if I take this statement as the hypothesis, that is A comma B and B comma C both belong to R. So can I confidently say that A comma C also belongs to R? So if AB and BC belongs to R, which is defined by this relation, can I confidently say that AC always belongs to R? So let us see. So AB belongs to R, that should imply A greater than B. B comma C belongs to R, that should imply B greater than C. So A is greater than B and B greater than C. So this should imply A is greater than C. And this should imply A comma C belongs to the relation R. So we have assumed that AB and BC belongs to R, and we can confidently prove that AC also belongs to R. Hence, it is a transitive function. So let us take another example, which we have already taken. Is a brother of. So is it a transitive relation? Is it a transitive relation? Yes. So let us see why this is. So let us say that an ordered pair of the form H1, H2 and H2, H3 belongs to R. This implies H1 is a brother of H2 and H2 is a brother of H1. So if H1 is a brother of H2, H1 has to be male. H2, if you have only this first statement, H2 can be either a boy or a girl. But the second statement says that H2 is the brother of H1. So H2 has to be a male. H2 has to be a male, and H3 from this statement can be male or female, whatever it is. So if these two statements are taken for granted, can I say that H1 is a brother of H3? Yes, because H1 is a male, H1 has to be a brother of H3. Hence, this is a transitive relation. So why is it called transitive relation? The relation can be transferred. That is, if A is a brother of B, B is a brother of C, C is a brother of D, D is a brother of E, E is a brother of F. Then I can say that A is a brother of F. The relation can be transferred. That is why this is called a transitive relation. So I hope you have understood what a transitive relation is. Let us take more examples once we complete the definitions. So till now, just try to understand what the definition is, how to apply it in very simple problems.